I would like to thank the organizing committee for the invitation to participate to the webinar. And
Yes.
My talk is about Honduras laparoscopic surgery for supracellular meningioma, our experience in well-selected cases. I will deal about tubercular cell meningioma. Surrounding important neurovascular structure is one of the difficulties of the treatment of tubercular cell meningioma. While the traditional transcranial technique approach have proven to be effective in removing this tumor, such frontopterional anterohemispheric transbasal and orbitozygomatic technique, recent years have shown the evolution and implementation of various minimally invasive approaches that offer the possibility of reducing brain and nerve retraction, minimizing incision size, and speeding patient recovery. Such the endoscopic condonazole approach, which we'll deal today with this approach, and the supraorbital keyhole minicraniotomy assisted by endoscope. However, these approaches are not suitable for all meningioma in this location, and STOM still benefit from more extensive and more traditional approaches. Decision-making and case selection are the keys of the two successful surgery. Endoscopic condonasal approach for tubercular cell meningioma. Endoscopic condonasal approach are well adopted in pituitary adenoma, but controversial still remain in tubercular cell meningioma. It represents an excellent alternative to transcranial approaches in selected cases.
Our selected cases. The first case is about a 62 years old female complaining since 12 months of visual disturbance and headache, and the endocrine function was normal. On examination, the visual acuity was 1/20 in the right side and 4/10 in the left side. Visual field showed bitemporal quadranopia and the fundoscopy was normal. MRI showed tuberculum cell meningioma with a size of 3 cm, median with dural tail without vessel encasement. This is MRI on coronal and sagittal approach, sagittal view with contrast, showing the meningioma, the supracellular tuberculum meningioma. The patient underwent surgery by endoscopic condonasal approach, by mononosterile approach. We resect the middle turbinate and we did the extended approach with drilling of the tuberculum cellae with the coagulation and vertical opening of the dura. We did the internal debulking of the meningioma and capsular dissection, and we obtained the gross total resection. The length of operation was 2 hours. The blood loss was about 150 milliliter, and there is no adhesion to vessel. And in the end of the operation, we did multi-layers reconstruction of skull base by fasciolata, bone, fat, glue, and nasoseptal flap without lumbar drainage. This is a view, perioperative view, and the outcome is very good with visual improvement without CSF leak, and the control MRI showed gross total resection. The visual symptom were improved, and after surgery, the visual acuity will become 4/10 in the right side and 10/10 in the left side, and the visual field was normal. This is the MRI, postoperative MRI. The second case is about a 44 years old female complaining since 6 months of visual disturbance. On ophthalmologic examination, we have in the visual acuity on the right side is 2/10 and in the left side 6/10. And the visual field showed the temporal hemianopia of the right eye. And in the fundoscopy, we note papilloderma stage 2. The endocrine, she has also endocrine dysfunction, hypocorticism, and the MRI showed tuberculum cell meningioma with a small size, 3 centimeters, with dural tail without vascular encasement. This is the MRI on axial, coronal, and sagittal. This is a CT scan, preoperative CT scan. This patient underwent surgery endoscopic endonasal approach, mononostril approach, and we did subtotal resection because of fibrous consistency. Length of operation was 2 hours, and estimated loss was 100 milliliters. We did not find arachnoid plane, and in the end of the intervention, we did multi-layers reconstruction of the skull base. The post-operative outcome is the visual symptoms are were stable with no CSF leak, and we note transient diabetes insipidus with hypopituitarism. This is the MRI, post-operative MRI. And the third case is about a 26 years old male complaining since 1 year of visual disturbance and headache. And on examination, the visual acuity on the right side, counting fingers at 2 meters, and in the left side, the visual acuity is 2/10. The visual field showed bitemporal hemianopia, and the fundoscopy was normal. In the endocrine laboratory, we note hypogonadism, and the MRI showed tuberculosis meningioma with a size of 3 to 4 centimeters without vascular encasement and no optical canal involvement. This is the MRI on axial, coronal, and sagittal view. The patient underwent surgery by endoscopic endonasal approach, by nostril approach, and we obtained gross total resection. The length of preparation is about 2 hours, and estimated blood loss about 50 milliliters. We did not note adhesion with vessel, and we did not note an arachnoid plane. And in the end of the operation, we did multi-layer reconstruction of the skull base without lumbar drainage. Postoperative outcome is very good with the rapid improvement of visual symptoms. Visual acuity in the right eye was on postoperation 10/10, and in the left eye 10/10, the visual field normal, and the fundoscopy it was normal without CSF leak, and we noted hypopituitarism. This is the early postoperative CT scan showing the complete removal of the meningioma. The fourth case is about a female, 48 years old, complaining since 8 months of visual disturbance and headache. And on examination, we noted visual acuity in the right eye 4/10 and in the left eye 6/10. And in the visual field, bilateral temporal hemianopia, the fundoscopy was normal. The MRI showed a tuberculosis meningioma with a size of 3 centimeters without optic nerve canal involvement and no vessel encasement. This is the MRI on sagittal and coronal view with contrast. This patient underwent surgery by endoscopic endonasal approach, mononostril approach, and we obtained the gross total resection. The length of operation is 2 hours and 30 minutes. The estimated blood loss is about 150 milliliters, and no vessel adhesion was seen, no arachnoid plan seen. And in the end of the operation, we did multi-layer reconstruction of the skull base without lumbar drainage. Outcome is good without diabetes insipidus. We note a transient CSF leak, and we note also amelioration of the visual acuity. In the right side, it was 8/10, and in the left side, 10/10. The visual field was normal, and fundoscopy was normal. This is the CT scan, postoperative CT scan. And we will compare the two groups. For the number is the same, for the gender is the same, no difference between the two groups. For the age, the first group, the mean age is 45, in the second group, 48. For the comorbidity, no difference. For the symptom onset, 10 months for the first group and 19 months for the second group. For the symptom, the visual disturbance and the headache, same for the two groups. Endocrine abnormality more in the first group. For the tumor, tumor size in the radiology, the tumor are more small in the first group, endoscopic endonasal approach. And the dural tail sign was seen more in the second group. The vascular encasement is more seen in the second group, three cases. And, for the other, no difference for the other feature. This is the cases operated by transcranial approach. The first case, huge supracellular meningioma, tuberculum cellular meningioma. The second case, the third case, and the fourth case. And we will compare the outcome, the surgery for the two groups. For the gross total resection, it's the same. The quality of the resection is the same on the two groups. The arachnoid plane was more seen in the second group, transcranial approach. The adhesion to vessel, vessels was more seen in the second group. The mean length of operation is less in the first group, endoscopic endonasal approach, and average estimated blood loss is less in the first group, 100 milliliter, compared to 220 milliliter in the second group. The quality of the resection is the same. This is the postoperative control for the first case with a complete resection. For the second case also, we compare the postoperative outcome of the two groups. For the first group, we have visual symptoms were improved in three cases more in the first group. And for the other, the complication the same, but the mean postoperative hospital stay was shorter in the first group than the transcranial approach. We reviewed the literature with a recent paper. And this is the recent paper, decision-making algorithm for minimally invasive approach to anterior based meningioma. And here there is an algorithm. The algorithm, the endoscopic endonasal approach, the limitation is the lateral extension. We cannot do the endoscopic endonasal approach in case of lateral extension. This is another paper, endoscopic endonasal versus open transcranial approach for skull-based meningioma. Another paper, endoscopic skull-based meningioma, another paper. Limit of the endoscopic transnasal to transtubercular approach, outcome after transcranial and endoscopic endonasal approach for tuberculum meningioma, selection of endoscopic or transcranial surgery, how to select for tuberculum cellular meningioma according to specific anatomical feature, retrospective multicenter analysis, skull-based approaches for tuberculum cellular meningioma, institutional experience in a series of 34 patients, surgical management of tuberculum cellular meningioma, transcranial approach or endoscopic endonasal approach, what to choose. The expanded endoscopic endonasal approach for treatment of tuberculum cellular meningioma in a series of 40 consecutive cases. And I think in conclusion, endoscopic endonasal approach is a good surgical alternative in well-selected tuberculum cellular meningioma, and which offer better visual improvement with speed recovery. The advantage of this approach is to attack the dura initially, the dural attachment coagulated initially. This is lead to low blood loss. We can obtain gross total resection with excision of the lesion, dural attachment and involved bone, and we can obtain Simpson 1 removal. No manipulation of optic nerve and the perforating vessel because we approach the meningioma from below. That lead to better visual improvement and no manipulation of frontal lobe, no olfactory damage, no cortical damage, no seizures, and reduction of hospital stay. But in the literature, we note more CSF leak in endoscopic endonasal approach than transcranial approach. and we recommend to do multi-layer reconstruction with lumbar drainage 3 to 5 days. What are the limits? The limits of this approach is the huge meningioma, the lateral extension, vessel encasement, and firm tumor consistency. The endoscopic endonasal approach requires excellent training with progressive, lead to the progressive learning curve and requires skills and experience. Take home message, endoscopic endonasal approach is recommended for small tubercular cella meningioma, less than 3 centimeters, with deep extension to the cella area or into the optic canal without vessel encasement and in case of soft consistency. And we obtain visual improvement with speed recovery. Whereas the transcranial approach is recommended for all cases, especially for the meningioma, a huge meningioma with size more than 3 centimeters, in case of vessel encasement, in case of lateral extension, and in case of firm consistency. And we take to this opportunity to invite you to the Maghrebian Congress of Neurosurgery, which will be held in Tunis on October 1, 2, and 3, 2033. And welcome to Tunis, and thank you for your attention. Thank you very much.